Yo, what's up, everybody? I'm so ready to play this. Hope you're all ready to watch. Let me get this set up here. It's been a while. I don't remember how to do all this stuff. Okay. That goes away. And then I push this button and I appear on the screen. Hey, there we go. Excellent. What's up, everybody? D-Sky, System Error, Cassispy. I'm ready to play. I don't know if I'm going to get through the whole case today or not, because I'm not really going to try and grind it out, but we're going to at least get started with case number 3. And I guess there's not much else to say. We should just start playing. Here we go. Let me know if the audio is messed up. It's Peach's birthday cake.
Catherine Hall!
And Jeff Masters. Piece of cake!
Catherine Hall and Jeff Masters. Piece of cake. What a jam. What? What's that got to do with my favorite cooking program? The Zodiac Art Gallery. All right. I think Ramza did it. I would like to leave. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. DL6, eat your heart out. The IS-7 incident. Manfred von Karma. Are we jumping back in time? Oh my goodness, we're jumping back in time. 18 years ago. Christmas Eve. Oh my goodness. Gregory Boys? My name is Gregory Edgeworth. Let's go. Ooh, Gregory thinking face emoji. There's some potential there. What a case to jump back to, the singing dude. So formal. Jeffrey Master. The world's greatest pastry chef, Jeff Master, the Master Chef. Now Ray singing too. It's like the Ace Attorney version of the Millennial Fair. Oh, look at the guard. The spirit fingers. The jazz hands. Ray with the, like, let's go. This is great. Oh, that music means it's back to business. Dessert contest. Isaac Dover. Afro Samurai. I was just going to point that out. Kind of reminded me a little bit. No, this, I didn't get any screechy audio. Oh, hey. It's this place. It's that place. Raymond Shields. Comes another song. Beautiful. Maybe I should tell my son about this show. Star-shaped cup, huh? What's up, Mod 366? What's up, Neptunia? Melodia, Godot. She discovered the body. Always tipping the hat.
Fork screener. Golden, this name is the most recent one of these. Ken.
What's a hoe?
No.
Whoa. I think you broke the the subscription thing, but thanks for the Twitch Prime sub, Jeremiah. Man, that was really hiccuping right there. I've still been meaning to add Bonesaw's sub notification too. He made one for me. That was from Zero Time Dilemma. But I haven't added that one in yet. Is it frozen? They refrigerate this room? Uh-oh. I'm Edgeworth. Bad. Tyrell, bad. Please don't be too concerned. I love Bad's expressions too. Isn't that ironic? Because that's the prosecutors that have been known to do that. Thank you. Nice. Way to win him over. Lollipop and grape juice, you know, the combo goes together pretty well. Patio and runs through every room. These are also sailing equipment. Oh, it's right in the center of the room that they discovered it. Have ideas already. The ship tipped over and crushed him.
Yeah.
beaten to death with a blunt object. Polaroid. I like his logic face. I think Gregory Edgeworth is like super interesting for some reason. All right. Was a sound that came from Mr. Master's room. Caused the ship to tip over. The ship fell over because the stand broke. Why did it break? I just made Gregory Edgeworth take damage. I feel so sorry. That purpose. You know what I'm saying? They might have been used for that purpose. Out everything. That's my job. That's a good quote. Whoa. That is an elegant mustache. I think I know who this is. I have a hunch. I know who this is. Dane Gustavia. That's not who I think it is. Oh my. Whoa. Whoa. What's he doing? Wow. Whoa. Wow. He's really talented. Candy Pumps. The title of the world's greatest. Ooh, they're playing for the recipe. Sir Master started judging at 3. Interesting. Okay. Master's room. Gustavi's room. Delicious room. Dover's room. So if Dover's room is the last one, in the middle of Gustavi is judging. Interesting. Oh yeah, it looks like there's a handprint there. Thank you. Journal of Regret. Running out of rum while drifting at the Red Sea has really made me red with regret. Nice. It's not lit. Oh, it's the Angel's recipe. Someone tried to steal it. Point out the problematic area.
Take that! Take that!
Yeah, everything's missing just like one piece. I didn't notice that. Wow. He wants Craig's coat. And the lighting. Minus 22. If you could set the room to minus 22, you could very easily freeze somebody. Thank you. Something tells me that the murder didn't take place in the treasure chest. I think it was set up to look like it was. Like, how convenient the ship fell on top of the chest. Beaten to death doesn't go with anything. Where's the photo that's... Let's check this. Victim's body was found in a treasure chest made of chocolate. The cause of death seems to be a hard blow to the head by a blunt object. But look where this fell.
Eureka!
It's not there. Someone took a piece of the chocolate. If you didn't preserve the chocolate, you could maybe get rid of the evidence. Nice investigation. Uh-oh, it's a master key. Yo, are we gonna duke it out right now with Bad? Oh, snap. Let's go. 1v1. Not bad logic, bad. Oh, yeah. Show him that evidence, Greg. That's irrelevant. Take that as a solid yes. Before the ship's fall, the treasure chest lid was closed. Oh, what are the contest rules? I didn't see this either. Contestants' rooms will be judged starting from the left. Afterwards, all parties will meet in Jeff's room. Any decorations not made from desserts are prohibited. Entering another contestant's room before the judging is done is prohibited. Wouldn't you have to open it? You don't mess with the Edgeworth. Looks like the ship broke it. Oh, he wouldn't have broken it. That makes sense. He's not in the room.
Objection.
Dust all of the chocolate. What do we got? Whose fingerprints are they anyway? Have it your way, Detective Burger King. That prosecutor. The living legend. To be continued. All right. I'm gonna take a quick break. We'll keep this going. All right, stick around, everybody. Okay. Give me 1 second here to set up and we'll get this thing back on the road. There we go. No, not that one. That one. There we go. Hey, I'm back. All right, so this case seems pretty interesting so far. A master key case. So the person who has the master key is always suspected, of course. Seems like this case has some pretty interesting rules to it, too, with how the judging is going. So there's some potential for people to walk around, meander a little bit. If you think about it, even though you can't necessarily unlock the doors, if you're not the one being judged, you have the ability to sort of wander around and do your own thing. All right, this is Delicia's room, or Delicia, or I'm not quite sure how to say that. Obviously, her desserts are very delicious, though. Wow, that's elaborate, to say the least. That orange lamp. The game is catching on to itself. Everyone, quickly say that. Now you're getting the hang of how to translate. Delicious scones. Nice. She's definitely the murderer. Ms. Delicious. Yo, Gregory is 34. Was in the castle. Classic Von Karma.
Objection.
Dude, Von Karma is an evil dude. Pleased to meet you, you vile man. Can't believe you missed the first 75 minutes. That's all right. You're here now. Things are just getting good. Planted some evidence so that I can find it. my name is Bad. Being on bad terms, you know what I mean? Missed opportunity by the translation team. I love the investigation music in this game. Holy crap. So good. I think one of two things is going on here. I think Von Karma is planting evidence and shifting rooms to avoid us. Or Von Karma just hates people. Could be that too. Why not both? I guess it could be both. Let's see what we got in Delicia's room. A burner. Number one, Punch Out, and number nine, Suffering. The forensics officer appears to be on a diet. So chocolate would not persist in her room. This is worth noting. It's too warm here. Is the ideal temperature for fresh cream. That too. Someone changed the temperature. Why can't I present this to him? I want to show him my attorney. Oh, oh. Take that. A candy fairy. Yeah, the temperature is bad. He won't make any friends. That's what I gained from that conversation, Bad Omen. Don't read law books if you want friends. Stay out of the way. I'll examine it. Let's turn the temperature down. My shoes got creamed. Oh, it's a real doorknob. That murder weapon? Plastic molds. Let's keep looking. Don't undersweet, mate. Thank you. Ray Ray. In the gardens. I don't think she's the murderer. At the moment, I'm leaning towards Gustavia being the murderer, I think. For a lot of the same reasons as that Bad was suspecting Jeff. Because if Jeff leaves the room and the body is discovered, isn't that equally beneficial if it's discovered while he's talking with Gustavia? Like, it's beneficial for Gustavia. So I think it might be him. It wasn't my intention to vandalize the room, except I utterly destroyed it. She knocked over a chocolate ship because she's so hungry. fake desserts and desserts study. Ooh, that didn't connect. I thought maybe she was just cheating to be in the contest so she could actually find out. She wants that recipe. Interesting. I think any of this is gonna matter. Okay. Well, bad, what do you think? Probably belong on these things out here. Bad with two D's, yeah. For the greatest logic segment ever. Putting both of these in the same picture. Man, Gregory feels brilliant right now. Can I do it? Why can't we put him in there? Dang. The victim appears to have been beaten to death by a fake dessert. No clues here. Bon karma planting evidence again. There's no cloth over there. Look, there's blood on this one. Could it be? Hide a tree in the forest.
Eureka!
What? Could it be that? Contest rules, I guess.
Eureka.
Delicia broke the rules. Delicia went to Mr. Master's room to study his desserts. Okay, how about bloodstained rock lamp and beaten to death? Those probably connect. Delicia broke the rules and fake desserts. Delicia is a fraud. I believe that she attempted to steal the angel recipe, which is why her handprint is on the angel recipe. I don't think she's the murderer, though. This figure doesn't maintain itself, you know. I know, that's why you went to the other room and ate a ship. She was going to copy. She's a fake. She doesn't want to talk about anything. No logic to be had. Don't be fooled by the fairies. All right, obviously this one should have a cloth over it too. Rainbow light device. Interesting. I feel like there's just, this is gonna be one of those cases where like everybody left the room to go to somebody else's room. They're all doing suspicious stuff. Let's talk it out, Von Karma. Good way to spend a Christmas Eve. Thank you. Oh, it's time to duel. Ergo. Objection! 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 They all sound so... so... old. That's wrong. Hang on to your hat, Greg. Oh, the Signet Crest.
Objection.
No?
Thank you.
In order to pin the crime on the ship, Master used the rock salt lamp to kill the victim. Each of the desserts in Mr. Master's room has one part missing. Before the ship's fall, the treasure chest lid is closed. Maybe we're just supposed to present that. Nice to use the rock salt lamp to kill the victim. If he had left the murder weapon at the crime scene, Master would have been the one suspected. But it very clearly belongs in her room. It's part of her setup. Body, but it was easy to move the murder weapon. I suppose that's true.
Objection.
Yeah. Just the tie. Just the tie. Look at this photograph. Man, okay, so I was thinking about this the other day. I really want to just get, like, a sound effect board to use during my stream. Perfect opportunity here for a look at this photograph. I'll have to work on making a soundboard. Hold it, Greggy. Comes the Von Karma trick. S- He's just like so happy to be found wrong. Debated. Oh, snap. It's not my nature to leave any doubts behind. Get wrecked, karma. This isn't good for bad. Thank you. harmony, it would just be this, I think. I wonder if she was like hired to sabotage it or something. I'm actually a pharmacist. I don't believe that either. Oh, so then maybe the ingredients were actually like pills, poison or something. Oh, he said it. Gregory is a savage. I think Gregory might be the base god, actually. Salty. What's up, Spooky Kabuki? I'm doing well. How are you? Really liking this game so far. So this is the room that was all the way on the right of the room. So we've seen the first room, the third room, and the fourth room, but we haven't seen the second room yet. Oh my. to be continued again. This case is getting interesting. I still think there's going to be some sort of like bizarre, like everybody's going to every other room sort of thing. Pretty cool. Okay. Let me take a quick break. Be back and keep going. Oh, hi. I'm back. This is the, third or fourth segment of this case already? Kind of cruising through here. So, let's keep it going. Here we go. I'm going to click that save button. And we'll go into the next twist. We've teleported forward in time now. This case is going to be like one of those that gets solved in the present, but like took place in the past or something. This is going to be so sick. Or no, there's... Okay, they're going to narrate it. Okay. That makes sense. The IS-7 incident. The room shifted? What's going on here? Oh, snap. At least he's honest. Ray is such a cool character. Love that dude. Mask to mask. Hey, wait, it's Pilot Lady and her boyfriend. What are they doing here? They're planning to steal it. That's a nice little reference. Who's this? Showed up. Or displaced. Selfie time. That's really good. Who's dead now? What the heck? Is that Larry Butts? What is he doing here? And why is Gustavia back? He dead. Hey, look who's back. It's a reunion. It's a murder reunion party. Ruckus allowed. It's not safe here. Poison gas? What the heck is going on? You know, I think Larry Butts has got to have the record for most times being around a murder as it happens and or being involved somehow. Dude is just involved in every murder. Is he being treated by Luna in the infirmary? Is Quark there too? Yeah, what if Larry committed all of the crimes? Larry Butts, ace murderer. It is unfortunate you were not hurt. Yo, I gotta write a note to myself at this moment in time, because this is one of the songs I was thinking of. Alright, Larry Butts theme. There we go. Just so classic. Ah, yes, Loris. This man is Larry Butts. Would smell just as much. What are you doing in a place like this? Yeah. Ray taking dating advice from Larry. I didn't do anything. Remember me? Wow. She's certainly developed. Oh my. Wow, Miss Kate has the golden voice. I'm jealous. Okay. I think I have some ideas. The whole point when they jump to Gregory's point of view. They're trying to misdirect you, I think. They're setting up all these characters that were involved. But maybe it's Kate that did it. Maybe Kate would have also had access to every room. She's wheeling a cart around so she could transport the body if she wanted to. I'm starting to think she's suspicious too. But why did they all come back? What was their motive for coming back? She could drug people with the drinks she serves too. Saucer's being chilled has anything to do with anything. Yo, look who's back. How about a hug? No. Nice gas mask, Edgy. Looks like Zero. What if Gumshoe is the next Zero? I'd play that game. What if there's a second master key? This case is getting really complicated and I like it. There's so much going on. or we're taking Larry Butt's testimony. I like it. Mayweather McGregor. I was debating if I even care enough to watch it. All I know is that for all the hype that the last Mayweather fight had with Pacquiao, I remember watching that and being extremely disappointed. It was just really boring. Like, the way that Mayweather fights is so boring to watch. He just, like, evades for 12 rounds. I don't know. I was debating watching it too. On the plus side, if one of your friends already has it, then you don't have to pay for it. So, how far is the trip? That's the real question. $12 each way. I don't know. It's up to you, I guess. I can tell you this. I don't plan on playing Ace Attorney all night. So, I'm going to keep playing. I'm probably going to eat pretty soon, actually. Take a break. And maybe play a little bit more. But I think later in the evening, we're going to do some Splatoon. I don't know around what time that would be, but maybe like closer to 9 or something. So, if that influences you at all. Yeah, I've heard like these ridiculous things about how much it's costing. Like pay-per-view just to buy it on your TV is like $100 or something. And then if you want to go to a Buffalo Wild Wings to watch, you got to pay $20 just to stand, like not even to get a table. $20 to get in the Buffalo Wild Wings. It's so stupid. That sport is just like, it's so weird to me how they can charge so much for one fight. And there's not even a guarantee that it'll go so long. You know, like it could be over immediately, or it could just go the entire time and neither player like significantly hits the other person, you know? I don't know. It's such a weird sport. When something smells, it's usually the butts. All right, Larry. I will expose your lies. Oh, I'm gonna play logic chess with Larry? Oh yeah. Here we go. Thank you. Right. Those people are blind. I almost wanted to pick that. Got him. What he was doing here at the art gallery. Oh, I was too passive? Oh, wow. Didn't realize I had to go on the offense right away. Did he sneak in? That's important. If she wasn't at the booth, that means she could have gone and messed with the sprinkler system. He's sweating bullets. I have no more use for you. Dang, I thought that was going to be the right answer. Ow! Thank you. fell out of the Winter Palace. The identity of the Winter Palace is like the biggest issue of this case. Everybody seems to have a different opinion on what room is the Winter Palace. Gemini sculpture wasn't there, probably. I like this new Bob Ross approach for Larry, though, in recent years. Really just adds to his character. Logic chess winner. So he thought he saw the Gemini sculpture, but he really saw the Pisces sculpture.
Take that.
What? What's happening? He saw a murder? What? It's an ice sculpture. What the heck's going on in this case? Thank you. This case is so weird. I love it. I wonder if the statue didn't actually transform, but it's actually using that fluorescent lighting that they talked about in the first part of the case. What is going on? Autumn Palace resembles the Winter Palace. It looks like the statues were swapped or something. Or why is the glass off the top of that one? How am I liking the game so far? I am liking it. A used gas burner. The cloth. See, I knew it. What's going to be inside? It's not going to be the other two statues. It's going to be a body. Or not. What in the world? If you wrap the cloth around the lower half, it looks like Gemini. No. DeBest and Courtney. Why?
I'll have to do that. He's accusing Larry Butts. Normalium and Fatalium. Good names. Megatoxin X. Nice. I really like how the bottle emphasizes it. There's like a skull on it. Megatoxin X. Interesting. The only one carrying paint was Larry Butts. Way to go, Larry. Mr. DeBest's shining logic. Oh my. Larry, just stay out of this.
Hold it.
This is a waste of time, he says. He doesn't have any Fatalium, obviously. Maybe I don't pay attention. I see. I presented it on the wrong thing. DeBest is a fool.
Ouch. Thanks for wasting everyone's time, DeBest. You're pretty good at that. How did the poison gas start? Doesn't it strike you as funny that there's a bunch of pink on this photo?
Take that.
Yeah, I mean, Ray is just a very much, he's a very hands-off kind of coach and mentor, you know? He only steps in when it's necessary to hug somebody. It's really kind of his approach. Furthermore, if they believe Larry is the culprit, why would they accept his sketch as evidence here? It's kind of weird. Overruled. Okay, there's based Courtney calling out the evidence. I knew she was bae for a reason.
Vacate the premises. Dude fell through the door.
Objection.
Yo, our boy Ray. Overruled. Oh, that's so savage. I feel bad for Larry. We're back to Delicia again. A 10-minute recess. I believe he does the eye bell, but he's that kind of guy, you know? He's very, you know, eyes on the prize sort of guy. So, interesting, unique, puzzling. So, it's 6 o'clock. So what I want to do is I've been playing for a couple hours. I'm going to take a break, make some food. I'm going to eat some food. Come back, and I'll play for a little bit longer tonight. I don't think we're going to finish the whole case tonight, but we'll play for a little bit longer. And then probably wrap up tomorrow. So I'll take like an hour break or something and be back with a little bit more. So come on back, and we'll see what happens in just a little bit. It's kind of like Ray has a hands-off approach with the girls. Yeah, that's the Larry way. At least Ray gets a hug sometimes. Usually from the murderer. But, okay. We'll see you guys in like 60 minutes or so. Maybe less. Bye for now.